She wanna rub my belly while we watching TV. I really want her to get up and make something to eat. Step out the house fresh when I go and get the bag. Popping bottles, popping tags. It's just somebody's fat boy swag.
Swag, 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 swag.
It's just somebody's fat boy swag.
Swag, 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 swag.
It's just somebody's fat boy swag. It's just somebody's fat boy swag. It's just somebody's fat boy swag.
Swag, 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 swag.
It's just somebody's fat boy swag.
Swag, 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 swag.
It's just somebody's fat boy swag.
All right, guys, welcome back to the UgnB Show on our growing YouTube channel. And you know what I need you guys to do? Go ahead and hit that subscribe button because you don't want to miss an episode, okay? So today we got my boy over here. Look at him over here. We got Sammye Alix in the building, y'all. Gosh.
Thank you for having me.
No problem.
I'm so grateful to be here and to meet you. Like,
goodness. To meet me. Little old me. So yeah, I had to go ahead and tell his daddy. Y'all seen on the last episode where I had to tell his mama daddy to go ahead and have him come on my show, okay? So that's why we're here today. So thank you so much for today. Coming all the way down from California.
I watched the last show with my parents on there and it was so good and so funny. I was cracking up. I mean, you're so great at what you do. So I could not be here, you know what I mean?
Listen to him, keep on talking to him. So I'm so excited to have you here. So I want the people to know all there is to know about you because I follow you on social media and y'all don't even realize this is like the first time that we talk all the time, but this is the first time we're actually meeting in person. So this is crazy.
Yeah, like years, I feel like. It's been years.
It's been years since I used to work where I used to work.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah, so if you can, tell the people a little about yourself.
All right, well, my name is Sammye, spelled with a Y-E. No way when you see it on paper, you know it's me. I live in Los Angeles for 14 years now, but I'm originally from Houston, Texas, H-Town. I have three beautiful kids. They inspire me and push me every day to be the best person I can be.
I'm a Scorpio, like one who walks on the beach. I love to go shopping, I love Balenciagas, I love diamonds and pearls.
Goodness.
And I love Janet Jackson, and I love to dance.
I just love to have fun, I love to be a light, I love to inspire people, and I love to witness my friends' dreams come true, and witness, you know, people living their best life, so that makes me happy.
Oh my goodness. So tell me some other things. So what are some of your, some of the artists that really inspire you in what you do?
Janet Jackson. Shout out to Mother Janet, I love her. Okay. I mean, she honestly is the reason why I became a dancer. I always liked her, I love Michael, of course. But my best friend, she loved Janet before me, and she had the Velvet Rope Tour. And she kept asking me to watch her tour, like every day. She's like, watch the tour, you need to watch the tour. And I never did, I kept putting it off. Until one day I was like, let me just watch it so she can stop asking me. So I put on the Velvet Rope Tour and I became obsessed, like with the show, with the production, with the choreography, like everything, with Janet, like everything. And when I saw that, I was like, that's what I want to do. I'm going to be a dancer. I'm going to do that. I'm going to go on a tour, gonna meet Janet. And and I don't know, she just really inspires me and I just love her so much. She's the reason why I became a dancer.
Wow.
Yeah, I love her.
Now, I've seen on your page sometimes, like I see you posting stuff with Janet Jackson. Now, how have you guys ever actually like met and like performed together?
Actually, I met her three times. I auditioned for her twice, maybe more, maybe twice for sure. No, actually three times I auditioned for her. I got to the end both times. I was on E! News with Janet on the screen at the audition and everything. Yeah, so I've gotten super, super close. When she did Super Bowl here in Houston, I was actually a dancer on the field for Super Bowl, but not for Janet, but she was there. So it's like, I've been around her so many times and I've gotten so, so close, like to where I could taste it, to where I smelled her perfume, you know what I mean? So not yet, but I feel it in my heart that it's going to happen because I manifest everything. So,
oh my goodness, yeah, it's gonna be sure. So dope, Sammye. Oh my goodness. So, you know, how did you come into this whole entertainment industry? I know that people are probably wondering, you know, how you came in. And we're gonna talk about all of the stuff that you've been in.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Wow. Well, when I was a kid, I loved MC Hammer. Like, He was so, right? He was so fun and so cool to me. So I would like always watch his dances and like do them at home. So the MC Hammer Running Man and a typewriter, I mean, yeah, all that stuff was like my favorite thing to do as a kid. So I loved him. He kind of pushed me to like dance. But then I also loved Barney as a kid. I know. I love Barney. And it was one black kid on there. His name was Derek. And I always felt like that should be me. Like, I felt like I was Derek. So as a kid, I would watch it and be like, that should be my part. I should be him, you know? And I don't know. I always, for some reason, felt like I wanted to be on TV. I wanted to be an entertainer. So I wanted to do, but not knowing how I was going to do it.
Yeah.
And I just kept pursuing it.
Okay. So fast forward to you actually taking the opportunity, because I know your dad and your mom talked about this a little bit. Yeah. With you actually, they packing you up and taking you over to Hollywood.
My little Honda, my little stick. Yeah. We drove. April 12th. We hit it. And we made it to LA. And I mean, I had a vision and a dream. That's what I really wanted to do. And my parents supported me 100% all the way. So when I told them, you know, I want to drive to LA. Can y'all drive with me? It was no hesitation. They're like, for sure, we're going, you know. Yeah. We packed up my Honda, my best friend, and we left. And I never looked back. That was 2006.
Wow. So did you have a plan? Like when you came out here, did you have a plan?
No, I had no plan. So you guys have to make a plan. Or not, up to you. But I did not. All I had was $1,400 and I had a dream. Wow. And I took that and I ran with it, like literally.
So who did you live with when you got down there? I mean, did you have a friend or somebody?
No, I did not. Luckily my dad, he's in the military. So they wanted to like stay with him. I think, I can't remember how he had some apartments or something there. I can't remember how it worked out. We were able to like stay in Riverside and we would drive to LA and look for places. They were there with me for a week. So me and my best friend and my parents were in LA looking for a week to find a place. And I think almost the last day we found a room for rent. So we shared a room in a two-bedroom like duplex. And that's how we first got started. We found a room the last day and the landlord, Marianne, she was amazing. She was so great and it just worked out from there.
Oh my goodness. You know, how much was that room? Because, you know, people always want to go to LA, but the thing is that they're not ready for is the price of the cost of living.
Right. Well, back then, it was 2006, it was much cheaper. I want to say their room was only like maybe $900. But that's really cheap because now it's way more than that. Like,
see me over here sweating, y'all.
But also at the time, for me, it was a lot because I'm from, you know, Houston is so different. And you sharing a room and it's $900, you know, but we got in where we fit in and it worked out. And I've been, like I said, I've been there ever since.
Okay, so take us back to your first big break. So I know that you've been in 53 episodes
of Hell's Kitchen. Hell's Kitchen. Oh my God, that was crazy. Well, yes. I was a costumer on the show. So okay. I was Gordon Ramsay's, like one of his costumers. I would get his chef coats ready for each episode and all the contestants and any appearances he would do, I would help them out with all that stuff. And I would actually try on a lot of clothes because he liked the way I looked in them. So I would try on the clothes, like some of his shirts and stuff. He'd be like, oh yeah, that's the shirt. Okay, that looks nice, you know? So yeah, that happened out of nowhere, actually. My first job in LA, I was a cashier at The Gap. At The Grove, it's a big outdoor mall, and stylists would come in, they would pull clothes. Mm-hmm. And I would see them like buying all these clothes, but then they're returning clothes. Yeah. I'm like, what are y'all doing? What's going on? And no one would tell me. Uh-huh. They would kind of like lie about their job. So one time I saw like a younger dude, he looked really cool. And I was like, okay, I'm gonna find out what's going on because there's no way. I'm so sick of this. Like, what's happening, you know? And he told me what he did. He was a stylist for commercials, and he gave me the number to his person that he was assisting. So I called her and she's like, well, have you done this before? Can you do this? And I was just like, yeah, sure, I can do it all. Had no idea what it was, how to do it.
Oh my God.
And I just agreed. So I got booked for a commercial and I just pretended like I knew what I was doing.
Oh, wow.
And I guess I did great because I kept doing it and then I got into the show.
So you've been in the 53 episodes of Hell's Kitchen. Yeah. You also did some work on your recent film, which is Bad Hair.
Yes.
So we're going to talk about that.
Okay.
And that's on Hulu, y'all. Y'all got to go and check that out on Hulu. Bad that Hair. Is going to be, it's amazing. I got a chance to watch it.
Oh, it's so crazy. It's so crazy. It's so funny. Crazy. Like,
I didn't know what my emotions were doing with me. Like some some parts I was like, oh, that was funny, but I was like, should I be laughing? Is it scary?
Right. Yeah. It's a little both, actually. Yeah. Like, it's a funny horror film with Vanessa Williams and Usher Raymond and Kelly Rowland.
Yeah.
Lena Waithe. And it was, it was amazing. I got a chance to, like, live my singing dream. Like, I can't sing at all.
Okay.
So you said that you don't sing, right?
I wish. I sing in the shower, in the car, and I can hold a note. I can sing with the group. But by myself, no.
I can sing just a little bit.
Oh, you know, I didn't have any teeth.
See, you know, I'm not supposed to play with you. But I got a chance to, like, live my singing dream and be in this boy group, kind of like Belle Biv DeVoe.
Okay.
We called the Fellas. So it was just fun learning, like, this new music and lip singing and, like, doing choreography. We only rehearsed, like, one day. We had one day of full rehearsals to, like, do three routines and know the songs and all that stuff, you know?
So, like, how do y'all, because I saw the videos, and we're going to show a little B-roll clip of the video. So, like, how do y'all create that chemistry where it looks like y'all have been together for years? You only have seen this person like one time.
Yeah, or just met them in rehearsal the day before or whatever it is. You know, I think just as performers and entertainers, we love our jobs so much. We naturally connect in that way.
Yeah.
Like, we want to do a great job. We all want to do good. Yeah. So, I don't know. And then you do become friends. When you're rehearsing for like 8 hours in the same room and you messing up or like trying to figure out steps and stuff, you do become close, you know?
Wow.
So, yeah. And also, movie magic. They make us look like we're like besties, you know?
You know? But yeah, so that is so dope. So tell me about your latest venture, which is The Masked Singer is one of them.
The Masked Singer's on right now on Fox.
Okay.
The Masked Singer every Wednesday. Shameless plug.
And what's your other project you got going on?
It's a new show called The Masked Dancer. It's a spinoff of The Masked Singer.
Okay.
But now celebrities are in masks and they dance, like Dance with the Stars kind of. The difference of this one now is that we, as dancers, we have a celebrity partner. Mm-hmm. So like Dance with the Stars, I dance with my partner throughout the show, mm-hmm. and hopefully she wins, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
He or she wins. So yeah, it's been so great. We filmed it already. It airs just on Fox.
So we get an exclusive here, guys. We get an exclusive.
Yes, it's been that show. I mean, honestly, one of my favorites to do, because a lot of times you work with artists, you may not get as close to people. Our celebrities as we did on the show. Like, my celebrity partner, we're best friends. We're besties. Like, we talk all the time now. And we just create this bond. And
yeah, I mean, because they're people too, you know?
Yeah, they are. But sometimes they have so much going on, and you don't get a chance to really interact with them like that.
Yeah.
Like, you may rehearse for, you know, weeks. The artists may come in the last 2 days. They rehearse and they leave. So you don't really get a chance to connect with them like we did for this TV show.
Yeah.
So I had the best time, and it was dance, so we were featured a lot, and I just connected with my partners so great, and it was emotional. It was an emotional show. Like,
wow.
I don't know, I felt something. So I'm so inspired all over again after that.
Oh, let's talk about some other things. So, you know, you talked about, you know, you moving out to LA, you starting your career and everything. Like, it's so hard for me because I just saw your Instagram picture today when you was posing with your shirt off and your legs out. I'm putting on the B-roll. The quads was popping. So I wanted to ask you this question. You know, I like to get a little deep and personal. So, like, are you ever insecure in this business?
Yes! Oh my gosh, you guys. I'm the worst. I'm super insecure. Like, I'm really bad. Being in LA and being in the industry, it can kind of make you that way. Especially being in a room full of beautiful people with amazing bodies and, you know, different body types, and you being judged against these people.
Yeah.
Sometimes you can be super insecure, and I am a lot. Like, I was a chubby kid. I had off moments, and when I was having my daughter, I felt like I was pregnant too. Like, I gained like 25, 30 pounds. So I was over 200 pounds and it wasn't muscle. So as a kid, I was chubby too. So even now, like, I work out a lot. I'm in shape now, but I still have that chubby kid inside of me.
Uh-huh.
It talks to me all the time. So yeah, I have to definitely push myself to not be that person, but I'm super insecure. So if you're insecure, it's okay. Happy to the best of us, but you know, you keep pushing. You got this. We got this.
Definitely, definitely. So tell a little bit about one of your other projects that you got coming up in January of 2021. I'm giving you guys the exclusive, so if you can, hear it first on the UgnB Show, okay? Yes. So tell us a little about what you're going to be launching here in January.
I'm so excited. My BFF, best fit friend and partner, JJ, or Jennifer Johnson, we have our fitness program together. It's called Bangin' Body. So it's, yes, B-A-N-G-I-N, apostrophe body, where we're going to change your body, but also change your mind and inspire you and encourage you to be better, to feel your best, and to be great. So we have the app coming out the end of January, where you can subscribe and over 100 workout videos and at the typical videos. We have twerk workout videos. We have it's yoga balance or some yoga hip hop too. Like, it's going to be a wide spectrum of everything you love. So if you love this work, I used to be in shape, get that body right. Bangin' Body is for you. I'm so excited. So the end of January, you get the app. We also have a Bangin' Body box that'll have our sliders, that'll have our bands, and everything you need to work out with us from the video. So okay. I'm so excited for you guys to show you our project and just show you.
So we're going to be able to have Sammye Alix in our pocket. Just, you know, easily. Take you wherever
you
we go.
Work out with me 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, no matter where you are in the world, no matter what time frame. I got you. Let's go.
Definitely. Yes. I love it. So we're going to show you a quick clip of a commercial here right after this.
Hi, I'm James Hunter. Welcome to Native Citizen. We're located at 2311 Dunlavy Street in Houston, Texas, in the Montrose area, on the corner of Dunlavy and Fairview. Here we do interior design. The art here is original. We have two local Houston artists, Edgar Medina and Sonia Cuellar, whose works are featured here in our gallery and studio. We're having a half off sale right now, running through the end of December, 50% off anything in our store, and I'd love for you to come by and see us.
All right, guys, we're back here at Native Citizen, and we're sitting here with Sammye Alix. Woo-hoo. Thank you so much for coming on the show. We just love you. So tell us, what is one of the most favorite or memorable projects that you worked on?
Wow, it's hard to pick one. I did a show for Nike in Puerto Rico some years ago, and we were there for 10 days, and it was beautiful. We hiked in the rainforest, and I prayed in this big waterfall, and I thank God, and it was just an inspiring experience. Working with Wayne Brady, who's such a cool dude. Like,
so tell me, how is it working with Wayne? Wayne seems like he's real dope.
Yes, he's dope. He's so funny. He's so giving, and he knows exactly what he wants, and his talent speaks for itself. Like, just seeing him do his thing, it just pushes you to be better and just kill it as well, you know? Nicole Scherzinger, Pussycat Dolls, I love her. We're so close, and she's phenomenal. Tracy Ellis Ross. She's hilarious. Like, what you see is who she is all the time. Like, I don't know. She said I had a butt like a Dyson vacuum. You know, like, little ball that moves around all the time. Like, she said that. And I was cracking up.
Tracy, go and look at my show, Tracy. Oh, my goodness. Okay, so Tracy, I know I'm probably going to meet you one day. Yeah. So, whenever we do meet, I mean, Tracy got it. She be talking about your booty. She got a booty, too.
Yeah, she is. She's gorgeous.
You got a dog. You got a dog, Tracy. You got a dog. Hey, look, wait a minute, Tracy.
Different show.
But shout out to you, Tracy. I have loved you. I have been obsessed with you since Girlfriends.
Really? I didn't know that.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my God.
I love Tracy Ellis Ross.
Oh my God. With us together.
Yeah. Yeah, we got to post it up there. We got to show it.
Okay.
God bless you. I just love you, and I wish you nothing but success in your endeavors. I've been loving you since Girlfriends, okay? Girlfriend.
One too. It's so good. Yeah. Right. I was just thinking in my head.
Can't help it. What is something that's really distinctive about you as an artist? Something that makes you just kind of stand out?
Okay. That's so interesting. That's a really good question. It's hard to talk about yourself in that way. But from what I hear from other people that talk to me about me as an artist, as a dancer, I am full out. You know what full out means? That means you give it your all the time. You give a lot of energy and you buck. You know what buck? You know, you buck with it. So when I dance, I perform, I'm definitely full out.
I give it my all. I may add a little extra like body rolls. I love a good like, like mass singer, you know, we're in masks on the stage. It's hard to figure out who we are. Mm-hmm. But my friends or dancers that know me, they always know which one is me because the way I move my body or something. Like, yeah. I have a little something extra, but I'm definitely full out. I dance hard. I go for it. You're dancing next to me, you better come on. We're going to pull up. We're gonna kill it. So be ready, you know. So I'm like, that's it.
Oh, my goodness.
Pull out Sammy.
Okay. Definitely. You are a ball of energy. You have such good light, such good energy. I mean, it lights up the room. Seriously.
Thank you so much. Seriously. The room has great lighting, so, you know.
The room got some good lighting. Got some good decor,
yes,
too.
Yes, you're amazing. So you have a great light and great energy about yourself, too. It's so easy to talk to, and you're so warm. So I thank you for having me.
I feel like I'm warm. You know, I'm over here, my T-zone is sweating.
T-zone.
My goodness.
Well, tell the kids out there, because, you know, I like to empower people. I like to educate people on my platform. So tell the kids out there that are trying to pursue, you know, things in the arts and move to L.A. and things like that.
Yes.
What would you tell them as some words of encouragement and inspiration?
Okay. I would definitely say dream big. No dream is too big or too small. So no matter what you want to do in life, go after your dreams. Visualize them. Like, hold on to them. Don't quit. No matter how old you get, no matter what anyone says, no matter how many no's you get, you have to keep pushing and know in your mind, know in your heart, and have the faith that your dreams will come true and that you will make it. Like, I've been in LA for 14 years and it hasn't always been easy. I haven't always been in the industry. I haven't always been successful in it. I've been told no a million and one times. I've seen my dreams crushed in my face. Like, seriously, but I didn't quit. And that's why I'm still in LA. That's why I'm still there. And I also have faith. And I pray constantly, and I visualize, and I believe constantly. So, like, you want that Range Rover, talk to myself. You get in your car now, you're on the freeway, wherever you are, you sit in your car, you visualize the car you want, you hold up to that steering wheel, you feel that, you feel the passion, you believe it, and that's how things come to you. Like I said earlier, I manifest everything, and I really mean what I say. Like, everything I wanted, I've gotten. And everything that I haven't gotten yet that I want, I'm going to get.
Yeah.
You know? Ooh. So you will too. Don't quit. You keep pushing. Dream big. You got this. For real, you got this. And if you have any encouragement, feel free to hit me up on Instagram or wherever you can, because I love to like encourage and talk to people about that in my story. So I'm here for you, like, seriously. And for
yes.
you.
Yes, I believe it. I definitely believe it, because like I said, this is the first time we met, but it feels like we've known each other. Well, we have known each other forever,
yeah.
But this is the first time we've actually met.
Like, I feel like I've met you already. Like, yeah. You know what I mean? Like, yeah. I feel like you're my cousin or something. Yeah. So, just natural.
Yeah, so I cannot wait to get out there to LA, because I am coming. I gotta go and visit my cousin Connie and young Josh, you know. I gotta go visit them. So whenever I come out there, I definitely gotta look you up.
Yeah, we're gonna turn up.
Okay, we're gonna turn up. Right. Just remember, you know, I'm a little old. This looks like you got the heart of a Hemi. I ain't gonna be able to do it. I'm gonna have to take
That's hilarious. That was
fun. I'm a little old, dude. You know, you're getting a little old out here.
Oh, my goodness.
But is there anything else you want to share with our fans and our followers out here?
Continue to support. Continue to subscribe. Tell your friends. Share.
Yeah.
Shout out to Alix Investments for hooking this up.
Please shout out to Alix Investments for hooking this whole ordeal up, and also Native Citizen as well. You guys got to check us out. I'm saying us like I'm part of the family. No, I think that I am part of the family. I'm part of the family. Y'all come over here and check out this. Yeah, check this place out. This gallery is amazing. Yes. I'm putting on the B-roll and let you see some of this beautiful stuff that's in here. But y'all would be remiss if y'all didn't come over here and check this out. Yes. Beautiful. So, oh, and they give you a little drink. Now, see, that's why I'm up here sweating a little bit.
Right?
Because the oil is good.
And it's Lord refreshing. Jesus. Mm-hmm. Mine's over there, but
they give you these little complimentary drinks. I'm over here just acting up. 2311 Dunlavy Street here in Houston, Texas. Please come out and check us out. And they have this on this sale where they have 50% off of everything in the store.
50% off?
50% off. Right in time for the holidays, too.
Perfect. Yes.
Look at God. Won't he do it?
Hallelujah.
But y'all, we thank you so much for watching our UgnB Show. We just love y'all to pieces. And you saw the commercial. Please come and check out our guy, James.
and he's gonna hook you up, all right? Tell him that Eugene sent you. Make sure that you like, rate, and subscribe on my show, okay? And hit that bell notification so you don't miss another episode, okay? Ding! All right, we'll holler at you. Peace.
It's just somebody's fat boy swag. Swag, 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 swag. It's just somebody's fat.